This video is sponsored by Grammarly. The worst has happened. You're making breakfast when you drop your toast on the floor. You quickly snatch it up before long and inspect it for dirt. You don't see anything, so you think to yourself, 5-second rule, before buttering one side and chowing down before school. Some surfaces scream, "I'm dirty," like the bathroom floor, but some don't immediately unveil themselves as carriers of filth and disease. Are certain surfaces less likely to transfer dirt, grime, and bacteria to your food, like ceramic or wood flooring? Is the 5-second rule a myth, or is it a truth universally acknowledged? When your beautiful slice of buttered toast lands square on the floor of your kitchen, do germs latch on immediately? Or is there a window in time that even the most malevolent microorganisms wouldn't be able to grab on? Wait, bacteria know about the 5-second rule, right? Grammar is important when you're writing for an audience. And, like it or not, bad grammar and spelling errors can make you sound unprofessional. This is why we use Grammarly to proofread our work. Don't be mistaken, Grammarly isn't just a grammar and spell checker as everyone thinks. It's a digital writing assistant that does much, much more. Making grammar mistakes isn't bad, nor does it mean that you're dumb. But when you want to ensure that no one holds them against you, editing is key. Grammarly is free to download and you can upgrade to the premium version for even more features to help you keep your writing efficient. For example, the tone detector is completely free and will help you tailor your writing to the right people or scenarios. However, in the premium version, there's vocabulary suggestions that can help you diversify your language, especially if you use the same words over and over again, like very. There are even the clarity suggestions that help you rewrite your sentences to cut down long-winded emails into sleek, concise messages your English teacher would be proud of. Most of our time is spent doing research, and thanks to Grammarly, cutting down on wasted time trying to figure out the best, most concise way to say something, it's definitely the GOAT of our writing toolset. That means greatest of all time, by the way. Instead of reading the same sentences 100 times to figure out if it sounds right, you can just look for Grammarly suggestions and you're already on your way. Save time and sound professional whether you're writing an application or answering important emails. Go to Grammarly.com/brew to sign up for a free account and get 20% off Grammarly Premium today to help you work more efficiently and secure that dream job or internship. And with that out of the way, let's get into it. The origin of the 5-second rule is somewhat unclear. According to writers Paul Dawson and Brian Sheldon in their book, Did You Just Eat That?, the concept can be traced back to the court of Genghis Khan, the medieval ruler of Mongolia who conquered pretty much everything between Korea and Poland. Oh, and also maybe brought the Black Plague to Europe in the early 13th century? That guy. The myth goes that the great Khan implemented a system called the Khan Rule. Any food that had fallen on the ground would be good to eat as long as the Khan allowed it. The Khan was so great that any food that was up to his standards would still be good even if it sat on the dirty floor for 12 hours. Delicious 12-hour aged floor beef. Fun fact, historians generally pin the death count of Genghis's conquest between 37 to 60 million people. So maybe dictating what food people were allowed to eat wasn't his most grievous character flaw. TV chef Julia Child has been accredited with popularizing the attitude, if not the 5-second rule itself. In an episode of her show, The French Chef, from 1963, she attempts to flip a potato pancake in a pan, but misses and drops some of it on the stove. She grabs it quickly and throws it back into the pan, saying, "When I flipped it, I didn't have the courage to do it the way I should've, but you can always pick it up if you're alone in the kitchen. Who's going to see?" Yeah, Julia, who is gonna see? But the first written iteration of a rule comes to us via Olympic gold medalist Brad Allen Lewis's 1995 novel, Wanted, Rowing Coach, stating that any food item that hit the floor was still considered edible if it was retrieved before 20 seconds had expired. The next shows up in 2001, in the animated film Osmosis Jones. Bill Murray fights a monkey for an egg, dropping it on the bottom of the zoo cage before eating it, sending his body into a terrible death spiral from the villainous Red Death pathogen, which the titular white blood cell, Osmosis Jones, must defeat. By the time the 5-second rule was showing up regularly in media, the idea that germs were attaching themselves to our food was likely already in the minds of the average person at home. But how did we get here? How did we first figure out that it was tiny creatures making us sick, and not like ghosts or something? The idea that unseen animals and particles in our environment could trigger illnesses is older than one might expect. As far back as 36 BCE, Roman philosopher Marcus Terentius Varro wrote that there are bred certain minute creatures which cannot be seen by the eyes, which float in the air and enter the body through the mouth and nose and there cause serious diseases. The problem is, even if you nail it on the first try, it doesn't matter if no one believes you. Just like my Pokemon Nuzlocke run. It wasn't until we had access to powerful magnification that anyone could prove this theory one way or another. Two men are generally credited with the discovery of microorganisms. The first, Robert Hooke, coined the term cell to describe the microscopic holes he saw in a slice of cork, circa 1665. He saw the wells of individual cork cells laid out and thought they looked like cells in a monastery. Unfortunately, to be able to see bacteria and animal cells, even stronger magnification was necessary. The second, Antony van Leeuwenhoek, managed to pull exactly that in the 1670s. He developed his own sets of microscopes to see even the smallest cells, and by all accounts, the microscope he made for this discovery was awkward at best. The lens was as large as a grain of rice, so Leeuwenhoek had to jam his eye right up against it to actually see anything. He saw sperm cells, blood cells, protozoa, bacteria, and algae cells too, dubbing them little animals. Because of these two men, germ theory found its beginning, though it would take another 200 years to connect these little animals to disease. And with that knowledge, the 5-second rule followed. How else should we make ourselves feel better about eating an apple slice that fell on the ground after we've just learned that it could be covered in gross little monsters that can make us sick? Well, easy. We come up with a cute lie. But is the 5-second rule just that? Well, lucky for us, food safety specialists Robin Miranda, PhD, and Donald W. Schaffner, PhD, were determined to find the answer. In a 2016 study, Miranda and Schaffner contaminated 4 different surfaces to see which foods and which surfaces are particularly at risk for bacterial adherence. They picked the bacteria, Enterobacter aerogenes, because it's non-pathogenic, which means it doesn't make you sick, but sticks to surfaces similarly to Salmonella. The 4 surfaces for their experiment were stainless steel, ceramic glazed tile, maple laminate wood, and indoor-outdoor carpet. The foods were watermelon, white unbuttered bread, white buttered bread, and gummy bears. The researchers disinfected everything, if possible, before trials. Miranda and Schaffner then made up a total of 128 contact scenarios, replicating each of them 20 times, totaling 2,560 total contact measurements. You know, everyone loves science until they're pressing a watermelon slice on carpet for the 160th time. So, what were their findings? Well, as it turns out, bacteria on a surface transfers onto your food pretty much instantly. Like any food dropped on the ground, the 5-second rule is destined for the trash. Or is it? When it comes to materials and foods, some are worse than others. Take a wild guess which was the worst. I'll wait. If you guessed watermelon, you'd be exactly right. It seems almost obvious that the wetter the food, the more it can pick up from the floor. Now, take a wild guess which one had the least bacterial transference. If you guessed the gummy bear, then you're 2 for 2. Generally, the study found that the moisture of the food is the biggest factor in how quickly bacteria can hitch a ride. Foods with a higher moisture level collected more bacteria, and vice versa. They also found that longer contact times resulted in more bacteria. Now, of the four surfaces, which one do you think transferred the least bacteria to the food? It's carpet. Carpet! Fuzzy, hairy carpet transferred the least amount of bacteria. How wild is that? Anybody? Okay. Instead of lying flat against the entire surface, the fluff makes it so very little of the food is actually in contact with the whole thing at once. In comparison to tile and stainless steel, carpet had a very low transfer rate, but wood was less consistent. Schaffner and Miranda note at the end of their research that this research shows that the 5-second rule is real, in the sense that longer contact time resulted in more transfer. It also shows that other factors, including the nature of the food and the surface, are of equal or greater importance. The reality of the situation is best summed up by the venerable Michael Stevens, best known by his stage name, Vsauce. He notes that the concept of touch at a molecular level is a lot more complicated than it might seem to our macro perspective. He says the 5-second rule may be true if we rename it the 1 femtosecond rule. Spend less time on the floor than that, and it's unlikely that room temperature molecules would have time to be influenced by intermolecular forces. That's a bunch of big words to say. If you can pick up your food in less than a quadrillionth of a second, you can rest easy knowing that the only bacteria on your food was already there to begin with. Hey, you know what's micro-awesome? Clicking that subscribe button and hitting that bell. Let these videos spread faster than a billion microorganisms on your toast. Let's get this bread. We out.